Hi there, this is Kristen. I'm the Science and Engineering Librarian at Miami University. This is one in a series of videos we have on patents, and it's all about the Cooperative Patent Classifications and where to find them. So what are the CPC codes and what are they used for? Well, it's a classification system that groups similar things together. This is like the Library of Congress or Dewey call number systems that libraries use for shelving books. We're talking about the CPC, Cooperative Patent Classification, developed in 2013 between the US and European patent offices. And that's what's used for new utility patents in the United States. However, just to complicate things, for design and plant patents, the US still uses their old classification scheme. In the older search interface for US patents, you really had to have the CPC codes or the patent number to find things. So while this is no longer the case, it is much better using keywords now. There is still value in knowing about these codes because you will see them when you're doing patent research and at times using them for your search. All right, just one more warning before we start. This example that I'm going to show you was planned out beforehand, so the video was not insanely long and boring. It's a very iterative process for everyone, even librarians who do a lot of searching. So please be aware that things are only going smoothly because this is not a live first attempt search. All right, let's dive in and find a code for unicycle frames. Okay, we've got our web browser open now, and we are at the USPTO's Classification Resources page. I'll have the link in the description. We can see we have two boxes here, the classification symbol lookup and the classification text search. We're going to start on the left with the text search as we have some keywords and we want some codes. The search on the right is for when you have the codes already. All right, so for our example, we're going to use unicycle frames. So let's type that in and we're going to leave it at all CPCs. You can search for the USPCs. Those are the older codes that I mentioned earlier, but we are looking for the CPCs. So we're going to leave this box checked and click on search. So here's the results page. It can be a little confusing to even know what to click on here. There's just a lot of trial and error to this process. Let's look. We wanted unicycle frames, and that's in bold for a few of the results. This one here is called CPC Scheme B62K. This is an example of the kind of code we're after. Cycles, cycle frames, cycle steering devices, etc. And it has unicycles in bold a little later on. This one here is CPC definition A63B, apparatus for physical training, gymnastics, swimming, climbing, or fencing, etc. That's not quite as focused on unicycles, so let's go with B62K. Okay, so on this page we have a classification guide and we have unicycles here, so that's good. We're on the right track. Recall that the CPC codes are a hierarchy of things. Along the top we can see where we are. The CPC section we are in is B, and then we're in CPC class B62, and then CPC subclass B62K. So let's open each of these things in a new tab and see what this is. So here we are in CPC section B, that is performing operations transporting. If we go back to the main page that we were on and click on class B62, we can see here that B62 is for land vehicles for traveling otherwise than on rails. Let's go back again. And then the subclass that we're in, B62K, is for cycles, cycle frames, cycle steering devices, rider-operated terminal controls, specially adapted for cycles, etc. So that's where we are right now. If we look, it breaks down even further. There's a huge surprise. We can see B62K, and then 1/00 is for unicycles, and that's what we were looking for. So let's just check. You may have noticed these little blue D's over at the side. We'll click on that and we'll get the definition. So we can see the definition for this one right up here at the top. Cycles with a single road engaging wheel. We can now confirm that this is the code that we want. While you're doing your own research, if you click on one of these definitions and that's not exactly what you were looking for, just remember that these are hierarchical, so like things are going to be grouped with like. All right, so that was a bit of a process. Let's review quickly and wrap up this video. CPC stands for Cooperative Patent Classification. These are the codes that we were working with today. They have a hierarchical structure, broad to narrow, where like things are grouped together. You can use these during patent research, including doing searches, and they combine nicely with keyword searching. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful to you. There are other videos in this series about patents, so please check those out as well.